guys. It is Thursday morning, 10:46 a.m., November 14th. I am going to work in this journal I made, I don't even know how long ago, this morning, and we're going to film part of it for a separate video, and I'll do some crocheting, catch up on daily drawing over there, and do some writing. I have some stuff I've boxed up for a friend. I've got some yarn I need to post on the local Buy Nothing group. We're having some stuff delivered this afternoon. It's just a chill stay-at-home day, which is fine. A lot of stuff kind of going on in the background, but I mean, I don't have to drive anywhere. I did enough driving yesterday. I did make a penguin last night. I'll put a picture here. He turned out really cute. I did find, it was either me or the pattern. To be honest, I'm not sure which, because I didn't make him until late in the day, but the math was off in the pattern, or my stitch count was off, more likely the latter than the former. But he turned out cute regardless. Is he perfect? No, but he's still cute. The next on the list in the book is a seal, I think. So anyway, all right, time to get on with this video. I'll be back. Hey guys, all right, so this cardboard journal I made a really long time ago. It's cardboard and old-fashioned packing tape that you have to like get wet. I don't remember where I got this idea from, but it wasn't my idea. Could have been Shannon Green, could have been somebody else. If anybody remembers, can you please let me know and we will link their channel, because I have absolutely no idea. Now the pages are pretty closely bound together, so putting too much inside is probably not going to be a good idea. But we're going to work in here and do something in this, because it's just been sitting in my closet since before I moved. It's been in my stash of stuff. And I've been living in Oregon 5.5 years now. So we're going to probably start with the cover. Maybe. I've got a bunch of stickers and things here next to me. And I'm going to just start grabbing stuff. And sticking it on, to be honest. There's not going to be any rhyme or reason to this. I don't do that anymore. I mostly use my art for therapy, and unbeknownst to myself, I think I've kind of been doing that all along, because all of my artwork for a long time has had words, text, or something in it. And when you want me to do something per a quote-unquote plan, I have like super hard time with that, because I think I want to just use it as therapy and ways to express myself, which honestly, when you're talking about art, that's what it should be. This is just some like peel and stick wallpaper from Dollar Tree. Is it going to stick super well to here? Maybe not, but at some point I'll probably cover the outside of packing tape. These are wall decals. I get a lot of these kind of stickery things from Dollar Tree and use them on my daily drawing journals and stuff. I like this one with all the trees. I'm not thinking, I'm just putting things down, by the way. We're not overanalyzing anything. Oops. Now, because most of these are like peel and stick type things, you do have to, you know, cover things in packing tape when you're done, if you don't want it to at some point peel off. Ripped that one. That's not gonna work. What else do I have? I have these birds. Do you want to put a bird on here? Maybe. Okay. Now I'm going to go grab the clear packing tape and we're going to cover that with clear packing tape. This is very similar to how I do my daily drawing journal covers, only bigger. You could, of course, glue everything down or something like that, but I'm a little lazy and I like tape. Okay, that's the cover. Put all this aside and we will open it up and we will work on our first page. Okay, I've gathered some things and some tape and some glue and let's get started. So I have still a stash of like journaling stuff, although I don't use it much anymore. So we're going to, I just picked a few things at random that like appealed to me. And some words and a picture. Of course, the picture has coffee in it because, you know. So we're gonna put those aside. First, I think we'll put some marks on here. I do have some weights over here underneath the side since the book is so thick, it doesn't wanna lie flat, but that helps me keep it open and flat. I have some homemade mark making tools I made a long time ago. And yeah, let's get started. Alright, so we are going to use a jelly plate. I have a jelly plate. I haven't used it in like forever. And we're going to change that up. So I'm going to put some. I use usually a gouache acrylic or a matte acrylic when I'm doing these things because it dries nice and matte and flat. And you don't have to worry about things because they're glossy, like sticking together and stuff like that. So, some white. I don't always use these particular brands of tubes, but I do have some other ones, but these were easier to grab. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is spread those out a little bit. Maybe blend them a little bit. Oops. Instead of wasting the paint on the brayer, maybe I'll do that. I am going to do that. I'm not gonna waste the marks. And let's see what happens. Might be too dark. This background of this cardboard is very dark. We'll see. Ha! Nope, that worked. That worked great. All right, again. I do need more weights over on this side because, as I don't know if you noticed, but the page started to bend. If there's leftover paint on things, we will just open the next page. It's about just having fun with the process and not being too worried about what happens. All right, I need that white back, because I want to use this. This is just a bunch of bottle caps at some point that I glued together. You can use that end or that end. I don't remember what the caps were from, but they were caps from something. Doesn't want to print on the cardboard, which is fine. Maybe if I push harder. Kind of. That's okay. Let's do it this way. I can't remember the last time I had my jelly plates out. They used to be like all the rage. I'm just choosing colors at random, you guys. I'm not overanalyzing anything, or at least I'm trying not to. This is like a paint brush thing I made a really long time ago. I actually have quite a few of these. This one I have never used before. I don't know why. Just feathers wrapped around a stick, literally. Makes interesting marks. Okay. I'll set that aside for a minute. I'm gonna get out some glue and start gluing some of these on. Again, this is about just expressing whatever is going on inside your mind, inside your soul. Doing some art for therapy's sake and not for any other reason. So don't overthink it. If you feel like drawing and doing proper artwork, then do. If you don't, don't. Again, don't overthink it. Okay. I need a pen. Do I need a pen? I need a pen or a pencil. Let's just use this. Okay. I'm just doing a rough sketch of something that I have the inspiration to put on here. And then I think just because it's here and it's handy, we'll use paint. And I think I want to use the brown. We're going to keep adding paint to the jelly plate and kind of use that as a paint cup. I might need a brush, but I'm going to see if I can just do this with a palette knife because I don't want it to be too perfect. Thank you. More paint. Okay, we're going to take what's on the jelly plate again and put it to the other page. Okay, I do feel like I need a some black. A paintbrush. So let's grab that. Normally I have some meditative music or something on in the background and I try hard not to get caught up in the perfection of the art because it's not about that. I don't always succeed, but you know. Okay, give it some pops of yellow. Yellow is a good color to lighten and brighten things. Not really going to clean the brush off too much. Just going to Just scrape it on a piece of paper. Why am I choosing these colors? I have absolutely no idea. Yep, that works. Okay. I have some masking tape. Why? I have no idea. Now, as the last step, I'm going to grab a pen of some sort, maybe a Sharpie, and I'm going to do some messy writing. Yep, there we go. I'll give you a better picture right about now. Okay, that is not the only way I do art journaling for therapy, but it is a way. I will be showing other ways in an upcoming video. Here's one or two of the pages I've done recently, and I'll be showing you how I did that. Not that some of you can't figure it out, but future videos will have less talking and more just creating. And I'll be showing you how I do it with a meditative music on in the background and stuff like that. So I hope it gives you guys some ideas of what you can do. And yeah, we'll take it from there. I'll be back. So there you go. It's very therapeutic. It helps clear my mind. I still do love art journaling. Yes, I know I've been doing a lot of other things lately, mostly vlogging, but this is still a thing I like to do. So I hope it gives you some ideas of what you can do, and you do share them here on YouTube or in my Facebook group, Life of Art and Self-Expression, and do tag me in the post, and I will see you in the next video. Go out and do something nice for yourself because you deserve it, and I'll see you later. Bye, guys.